Creating shapes in Illustrator can be slow. I'm going to show you a quicker way. Hopefully you watched the previous geometric shapes episode so you can make a basic shape using the panel or the shortcuts. Like the geometric shapes, we have to activate the dynamic shapes tool, which automatically opens our panel. We could pick our shape, fine-tune the settings and double-click, but instead I'm going to click and drag. As long as I keep the mouse held down, I can make changes using our shortcuts. As the geometric shapes took up the shortcuts 1 to 7, we're instead going to use 9 and 0 to tab backwards and forwards through this second row of shapes. The tool remembers the previous settings and transfers them across the different shape types, so you can get something looking quite odd. But remember, to remedy this, we just need to use the B key to return it to its basic shape. I'm happy with that, so I'm going to release the mouse, finalising the shape. If we take a closer look, a second difference you'll find is at the bottom of the panel, there will be very specific settings for that shape. So in this case, with the cross, we've got a thickness and offset. So instead of changing the values in these boxes, I'm going to work more intuitively and go straight to these red annotations, which we know can be clicked and dragged to make changes. Well, actually, there are a couple of additional annotations with these shapes. Instead of the slice handle, we have a lollipop, which rotates the shape. And then, and it's a subtle difference, we have these red squares within red squares, as well as a dotted line. As with the others, you just click and drag. These refine our settings that are specific to that shape. And it's these annotations that will allow you to specify the shape to your needs. If you want to know more about dynamic shapes, just check out our other videos.